we are going to start the skeletal system. So we'll look at the bones. That packet with the pictures, we are going to have quizzes over all that. We'll split it up so it's not all at once. But
we have one that's all at one time?
No.
Okay.
That's good. Yep. We'll have quizzes over those. Whoa. So the functions of the skeletal system, support, so the bone is hard and rigid, that way it can support your body weight so you're able to stand.
Do you want to do some typing?
Okay, then protection, because the skull around your brain protect, or the skull protects your brain, your ribs, and sternum and vertebrae protect like your lungs and your heart. The spinal column, the vertebrae protect your spinal cord, so it protects a lot of your organs. The movement is produced by muscles on the bones from the tendons. So if you didn't have a bone to attach to, you wouldn't get any movement. Storage, it stores calcium and phosphorus, and then it's stored and then released as needed. So if your blood calcium level decreases, you're going to be able to release calcium. If your blood calcium levels are high, you'll store more calcium. And then fat is also stored in the marrow cavities. And then blood cell production occurs in the red bone marrow. Why is it going to... So we have bone, cartilage, tendons, and ligaments. Cartilage, there's three types: hyaline, fibrocartilage, elastic cartilage. We've talked about those three when we talked about connective tissue. So we'll talk about cartilage first. Hyaline cartilage is the most common. And it has specialized cells that produce matrix. So we have chondroblasts. Remember, chondro is the prefix for a cartilage. So chondroblasts build cartilage. Build the matrix. Chondrocytes are maintaining the matrix, and they're in what's called a lacunae, and they're little hollow spots where that's the lanula. Lacunae are little hollow spots where the chondrocyte would be located, and so the matrix is made up of collagen fibers and proteoglycans. If you remember proteoglycans from the tissues. That looked like they compared it to like pine branches because it's branched, very highly branched, and that kind of holds the water in it, captures some water, so it's more resilient. It's also called articular cartilage because a lot of hyaline cartilage is located at the articulations, which are joints. So all of the joints, all the bones at a joint is covered with hyaline cartilage. Kind of reduces frictions, gives it a smooth surface to slide against. And then it can grow two different ways. There's appositional growth, interstitial growth. Appositional growth is when the new chondrocytes and new matrix are made on the periphery, so it's getting on the outside of the cartilage. It's growing either wider or a little longer just on the outside. Interstitial is within the tissue where there's going to be more matrix between the cells then. So the bone matrix itself is kind of like reinforced concrete where you have rebar running through this concrete, giving it more stability. And there's collagen fibers then running through this hydroxyapatite. And if you need both, if the mineral part is removed, the hydroxyapatite part is removed, the bone is then too bendable, which is on the bottom left. If the collagen is removed, which would be like the rebar, then the bone becomes too brittle and it shatters easily. So you need a mixture of both. So the bone cells are osteoblasts, osteocytes, osteoclasts. And the stem cells are osteochondral progenitor cells, is the cells that develop into those three bone cells. So osteoblasts will help build bones. So if your blood calcium levels get too high, it'll take calcium out of your blood and build more bone. If it gets the blood calcium level gets low, it's going to break down bone, release the calcium and phosphorus into your blood, so you'd have more there. Then we're going to look at cancellous and compact bone also. We've kind of talked about it a little bit, but we'll talk about it more. So osteoblasts form bone through a process called ossification. We're going to go through, there's two different types of ossification. We'll go through that next week sometime. Osteoblasts communicate through gap junctions, and then they're surrounded by matrix. The osteocyte is in mature bone cells. They're in the lacunae, which are this little spaces occupied by the osteocyte. And they're able to just make a little bit of matrix just so that they can maintain the amount of matrix. And the matrix is the collagen and the hydroxyapatite. So here's the cancellous bone, the spongy bone. They have that trabeculae, and they compare it to scaffolding. But all these spaces, or all these bone lines here, the rods or plates that go in between, those are the trabeculae, and then there's spaces. And all of this is covered with endosteum, which is just a membrane around the inside of a bone. Compact bone are those the bone that looked like the tree rings. And there's a central Haversian canal, which this picture is, I wish it was bigger. You can look at one in your book, but we'll go through this. This is the central Haversian canal, and that is, it'd be parallel to the axes, so if you're looking at your radius, it would be the Haversian canal would go this direction down your radius, the long way down a bone. It holds blood vessels go through that, so you get your nutrients and stuff through that Haversian canal. The lamellae are the concentric circumferential circles, like the tree rings that are going around. The ossean or Haversian system is this whole system, this whole tree ring picture, that whole area. And the caniculi is, you can't see it very well in this picture, but there'd be like cracks coming out, radiating away from that Haversian canal, and that's what that is. And then all these little darker spots around on the tree rings, those are the lacunae, where the osteocytes are. So then you can see here there's one Haversian canal, another Haversian canal, another one. So it's just several tree rings all put together.
So where's the bone system?
It'd be not inside this, like in this hollow space over here.
Oh.
So there's a couple bone shapes. Long is where it's longer than it is wide. Your upper and lower limbs, your radius, ulna, humerus, femur, tibia, and fibula are all long bones. Short bones are like your carpals and tarsals. They are as wide as they are long. So your carpals and tarsals, how you can remember, carpals are in your wrist bones. So you drive a car, you're using your hands, wrist bones, or you could think of carpal tunnel syndrome is in your wrist. Tarsals, you'd step on tar with your foot or the Tar Heels if you're a UNC fan. So they are in your foot, in your ankle. Nope. Flat bones are like your ribs, sternum, skull, and your scapula. And then irregular, just have weird shapes. They don't really fall in the other three categories. Vertebrae are those, and then a lot of your facial bones. No, it's just long. So the structure of a long bone, we have a diaphysis, which is the shaft, the length of the bone, and it's made up of compact bone, and then it's hollow in the middle, filled with bone marrow. The epiphysis is at the end of the bone, so you'd have two, I don't really know what the plural is, epiphyses. Epiphysis would be singular, though, I think. So you'd have two, though, at the top and the bottom of the bone. In the middle is the diaphysis, and it's made up of cancellous bone. And then there's an epiphyseal plate, which is your growth plate. It's made up of hyaline cartilage, and it's always there until it growth stops. So right here is an epiphyseal plate, and right here also. So that is the plate that if you break a bone, a long bone, they're worried about it, the growth continuing, whether or not it's going to continue growing. And then once you get old enough, the bone will stop growing, and this cartilage, the hyaline cartilage, will then turn into bone, and you'll just have an epiphyseal line. You'll still have that line there. And the medullary cavity is the where the red bone marrow is, down the diaphysis. And it's all when you're a child, it's all red bone marrow. Then as you grow older, it is converted into yellow bone marrow, is replaced by yellow marrow. The epiphyses will usually stay as red bone marrow, but the diaphysis would change to yellow. Then we have a couple coverings. I don't know, it's not necessarily a membrane, but it's a covering. And the periosteum is the outer covering, so it's on the outside of the bone. And it's very fibrous. It's a single layer of bone cells. And those fibers actually are continuous with fibers of the tendon that touch the muscles. So the tendon isn't just kind of glued on there or attached to the bone. It's actually an extension of the bone, so it's very interwoven, which makes it a lot harder to tear. It's not going to pull off very easily. And then the endosteum is that same type of covering, but it's on the inside of the bone, like in the medullary cavity or along the trabeculae. It lines all the internal spaces.
Mm-hmm. So, like, if you tear a ligament,
you have to fill it. No, you have to replace it then. And so when they, we'll watch ACL reconstruction, which is the ligament, but they, because there's no blood circulation there. That's why they have to replace it more. And what they do is they take a screw and screw the tendon into your bone. And that's how they hold it there then. Mm-hmm. Flat bones, there's no diaphyses or epiphyses because it doesn't have one end or another. It's just flat. So it's basically a sandwich of cancellous bone, spongy bone, in between compact bone. So that compact bone then, or the spongy bone, is filled with red bone marrow also. Then shorter, irregular bones are compact bone that surround the cancellous bone center. So there's always spongy bone in the middle, but there's no diaphyses or it's not elongated. So, and then there are some flat and irregular bones of your skull that have sinuses, which are just big cavities that are lined by mucous membranes, and that's for your nasal sinuses. And I believe that's it for the day.
You.